macOS Big Sur is the latest operating system release for the Mac and introduces many new features to make your Mac experience more optimized and refined than ever before. In this video, we're going to cover 6 major changes made to Big Sur so you can take advantage of the new capabilities it has to offer. This is Greg with Apple Explained, and I want to thank MacPaw for sponsoring this video. First, let's talk about its improved interface. Applications in Big Sur feature something called full height sidebars, and the easiest way to understand what those are is to compare them to the previous sidebars in Catalina. Let's take the Mail app for example. With this old interface, the mailbox sidebar had a height limitation due to the toolbar above it. And that not only added visual complexity, but reduced functionality since the toolbar was impeding on the user's content area. But with the new Mail app in Big Sur, you'll find that the mailbox sidebar extends to the very top of the window, and the same goes for the inbox column. When it comes to the message area, Apple consolidated all the controls at the very top, so they're not only easier to find, but they no longer impede on other parts of the interface, as they had in older versions of macOS. The next big change to Big Sur is its dock. This is what we were all used to seeing with Catalina, a dock that had several different shapes of icons, round, square, circular. There was very little visual consistency in their design, but all that changed with Big Sur. Here's how the new dock looks. Not only are the icons themselves a uniform shape, just like iOS, but the dock has also been rounded at the corners to perfectly accommodate the new icons. But this design decision wasn't just for looks. If you own a Mac with Apple's new M1 chip, you can actually run iOS and iPad apps natively. And because of the new dock design, the iOS icons fit perfectly among the existing icons in macOS, so the experience remains seamless and consistent. Next is the addition of Control Center. This is a feature we've been enjoying for years on iOS, and it's finally coming to the Mac with Big Sur. You can activate Control Center by clicking this icon located in the menu bar, and here you can quickly access controls you use most on your Mac, like managing music playback or enabling Do Not Disturb. For even more convenience, you can drag and drop your favorite controls to the menu bar, creating shortcuts for certain actions. And if you want to add controls that aren't already included, you can do that in Settings. Next, let's talk about all the improvements to Safari. For the first time ever, Big Sur users can set a background image for their Safari start page. But that's not all. You can also decide what information appears, like your most frequently visited sites, Siri suggestions, and iCloud tabs. There's also a new category in the Mac App Store called Safari Extensions, which provides an improved experience when browsing and downloading new extensions. But one issue Mac users still have today is running out of storage space, which is why I recommend using CleanMyMacX to clear out old clutter and prepare it for new macOS releases like Big Sur. Macs do accumulate junk files that you may have only needed temporarily, but permanently take up space. That's why I run a smart scan on my MacBook Pro every week, which removes about 10 gigabytes of clutter every time. It also helps you view and manage application permissions, scans your system to identify and remove any malware, and gives you an overview of what files and applications are taking up the most space, so you can easily remove large files you don't need. You can try out CleanMyMacX for free using the link in the description, and if you like the product, the upgrade is only $35 annually. Also new to Safari are instant page previews. They appear when hovering over tabs so you can quickly navigate to the one you're looking for. Website translation has also been added to Safari. The translation icon will appear when you navigate to a supported foreign website and allows you to read the articles and headlines without the need to translate everything manually. Apple has been implementing a number of privacy features in their products lately, and the same goes for Safari, which saw the addition of Privacy Report, a tool that identifies trackers and helps prevent them from profiling or following you across the web. Next, let's turn to Messages, which features some much-needed updates to keep up with iOS 14. The first being pinned conversations. You can now keep important conversations pinned to the top of your list, so they're always within reach. And the best part is that the conversations stay pinned across all your devices, so you don't have to do it manually on your Mac and then your iPhone and then your iPad. Inline replies are also here, which is one of my favorite features. If you're in a group chat with messages flying all over the place, it can be difficult to understand who's replying to what message. Now, you can select a message and reply directly to it, so everyone can easily follow the conversation. It's also easy to call out specific people with mentions. When you're mentioned, your name is highlighted. You can even customize an active group so you only receive notifications when you're being mentioned. That way, everyone gets the information relevant to them instead of wasting time reading messages meant for someone else. And just like on iOS, Mac users can discover trending images and GIFs and instantly add them to any message to make your conversation more fun and your replies more expressive. Speaking of fun and expressive, message effects have officially been brought to the Mac. Previously, when you received a message from an iPhone with an effect, macOS simply told you which effect it was sent with. But now you can see them and send them, with effects like balloons, invisible ink, and confetti. Now, perhaps the most underrated improvement to messages is search. Previously, trying to locate an old message was clumsy and time-consuming. But now, messages will quickly search your entire thread history to locate certain keywords, which takes the headache out of finding that special message from last year. Now, let's talk about maps. Apple has added support for guides in Big Sur, which allows you to discover new places to eat, shop, and explore. You can also create your own guides and share them with family and friends. Cycling directions have also been brought to maps. From elevation changes to live street traffic, you'll have all the tools you need to plan the perfect bike ride. When you're finished planning the route, you can simply send it to your iPhone and hit the road. The highly anticipated look around feature is Apple's answer to Street View on Google Maps, allowing you to drop into a specific location and explore the area as if you were actually there. There are also indoor maps in this update, allowing you to browse detailed interior layouts of major airports and shopping areas before you even leave home. But that's not all, there are a few extra features worth mentioning, like app privacy labels that show you what type of data a specific app collects, how they track you, and how your data is used. Also, the new video editing feature in Photos, where you can actually edit a video the same way you edit a photo. This is super helpful if you need to quickly crop or rotate a photo that was recorded in the wrong orientation. Lastly is AirPods seamless device switching. If you were listening to audio on your iPhone and then began using your iPad, you'll see this notification on your phone and a similar notification on your iPad that your AirPods were connected automatically. Well, you can now enjoy that same experience on your Mac with Big Sur, allowing your AirPods to seamlessly keep up with your workflow as you switch between devices. So that's what's new with macOS Big Sur. Thank you guys for watching till the end, and I'll see you in the next video.